What's up guys, it's Lindsay and I'm back for another video. So, I may have done some damage at the bins last weekend. We're gonna get into it, we're gonna talk about it. Went to the bins last weekend and my whole goal was actually to get a lot. So this is what I was wanting to do. Not knowing what the weather was gonna do coming into this current weekend, it was originally predicted that we were supposed to have like 7 inches of snow and tons of ice, but we ended up not getting any snow. So I was trying to prep to get inventory basically for this weekend, especially with it being a 3-day weekend, so that I had stuff to photograph because I probably was not going to be driving anywhere. But I kind of have bins amnesia at the moment and I don't really remember what it is that I picked up because it's been a week. I believe it ended up being like 43 or 44 items, and because I got a lot of light stuff this time and not like sweaters and jackets and things, I think my cost of goods brought it down to about $1.60, which has not happened probably since my very early on bins trips. So let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, so the first thing right off the top, I do remember these. These are Levi's Premium Rib Cage Boot, which I just talked about in my brands that I picked up frequently like last year. And these are just a corduroy boot. These were small size. They're size 26 and I think the inseam on them is 33. The only thing is that they did have, I do remember these having a flaw. Yeah, there's a flaw right on the back here. I did try to stain treat it, but it would not come out. But they're Levi's Premiums, and I still think that someone will be interested in them. This is a vintage youth, well, this says youth large is a 7. I think youth 7s are like smalls nowadays, I think. But the brand is Cut Loose, and it's just this cute little vintage little kid's cardigan cable knit. I just think this is so adorable. My standard go-to vintage Lauren, Ralph Lauren, and this is just a standard yellow striped button-up. I can't remember if this is a line that is discontinued or not, but this is a diffusion line from Ralph Lauren, and this is Denim & Supply. And this is a size, it's a size small, but it is a military jacket with the, or a military style jacket. There was a specific style name when I looked this up and I can't remember what it was. Oh, this was just kind of a toss in. This is a vintage Coors Light NFL shirt, and it's on a Gildan size XL. This thing is thrashed and stained pretty heavily, so some people love this. And this is washed, by the way. So this is washed and none of these came out. This is such a cute dress, and I hesitated only because I don't really know anything about this brand. I think I've picked it up before maybe, but I can't remember. This is a Jessica Howard size 6, but this is just like a little fit and flare dress. And it's got these floral, like gold, metallic. It looks kind of frumpy on camera, but this is so cute in person. And this would be so slimming on someone. Next, this is a vintage A.G. Buyer California. This is maybe like snakeskin, is that the print? I'm not sure, but it is a size extra large and it's like satin. Okay, this is also a fun find. I did not even know that these were a thing. So this is a University of Washington full zip hoodie. And it's got this on the back, but this is from ESPNU, and I didn't even know ESPNU had clothes, but it's got the ESPNU zipper pull, and I think when I looked them up, it seemed like they were age range probably like 2007 to 2009, like somewhere in that time frame. Next is, I love finding and selling these because they typically do pretty well. This is a vintage Maiden Form size 34. Just a little like lace bodysuit. This is a vintage Beehive Clothing Mills, size small. This is the tag right there. I've never seen this one before, but this is just like a white long sleep dress. Could be just like a slip too, just like a under slip. This is the first time I think I have ever found Rock Revivals. I have never found Rock Revivals ever. So here's that. Obviously, if you don't know Rock Revivals, they're the ones with the very eccentric pockets that normally have a bunch of like bedazzling and stuff. These aren't quite as eccentric as they could be. These, though, are definitely an older style because it's a very, very low, very low rise. It's got the distressing all along the front. The bottoms are pretty good. Nothing wrong there. These are the Yazi, I don't know, style. It's a boot cut and they are size 27s. There's a funny story to this one. So I was in a fresh bin and I found this, and as soon as you see it, yep, you're gonna know what it is. That is Tory Burch, and it's a size 6. So the funny thing is that this was like laying in the side of the bin like this, and all I saw were the gold buttons, and I was like, that looks like it could be kind of expensive. I didn't see the brand tag, so I didn't know what it was. And there was a girl literally standing right next to me, like we were shoulder to shoulder almost, and she was kind of like digging over the top, and this was right underneath, like kind of up by her waist, and I leaned over and I was like, oh, excuse me, can I grab that? And so I pulled it, and as soon as I pulled it, I was like, oh, I'm glad I pulled it. And then she kind of looked at me like, oh, why, what was it? And then I showed it to her and she was like, oh. Because I think she was disappointed because it was literally right under where she was digging. But when I looked this up, this is the Bridget style. And unfortunately, these only sell for about $25 to $30. So this is not as high of a Tory Burch sale as I was expecting it to be. This is another like vintage dress. This is by the brand Kaser. Has an E, so I'm assuming it's Kaser. This one is really pretty. This has got like lace, it's got like lace straps, if that's what you want to call it. And it's kind of got this like crisscross front, and then it ties in the back. This is definitely a midi length. It goes, depending on your height, it would probably go all the way to your ankle, but it's definitely a longer style. This was a Young Fabulous and Broke size large, and I don't think I've ever sold this brand because I know it used to do really well like back in the day, but now I don't think it does nearly as well. This is like a, it's kind of like a peasant dress kind of, because it's got the tiers, but it's like this gorgeous like dark greenish, it's like a dark green aqua. But here's the tag, size large, great size. This is a vintage Jennifer Moore, size 6. I just thought this was really pretty. Here's the tag on that. I just thought this was super pretty. This is, again, a midi skirt. It's kind of like an A-line, but it's just like super flowy. These are vintage Winnie the Pooh sleep pants, and these are like capri length. And these are the vintage Disney Store, size medium. Probably only gonna sell for like 15 or 20 bucks, but I think I've said this in previous videos, I love finding vintage Winnie the Pooh. This is a vintage Adidas, size women's large. And this is just like a little like half zip pullover jacket. It's got the Adidas down there, worn off. And then it's got the like, mesh ventilation on the back here. But I think I looked this up and I believe this particular Adidas tag, I think, was from the 80s. So these are, as you guessed, these are Lululemon. Not sure on the style yet. I don't know if these are the Wonder Unders or if they're the Aligns, but they're definitely longer and they're this pretty rose color. These, I believe, are a size 2. Yep, they're a size 2. This is one of the newer-ish, you know, Lululemons, because it does have all the numbers around the edge there. And then I found this Howard University sweatshirt. This is a Champion size medium, so this should do pretty well. This is a really, really fun local find. If anyone is from the Washington State, you know, Seattle area, you would know that Dick's is a burger restaurant that has, it's a drive-in that's kind of, it's been there forever. So I found this really cool vintage Dick's bomber jacket. The only thing is that down here at the bottom it does have a rip, but it doesn't go all the way through to the liner, so if you don't care about that, you know, that's fine. It is by ASW Jackets, and I have no idea on the size, but my guess is it's probably a medium. Next, this is a youth jersey, Seahawks jersey. I don't really typically pick up jerseys, but Lynch is the one exception because I love him. He was my favorite player on our team. So this is a youth size small. This is a brand that I've picked up in the past. So this is a vintage silhouette size 20. The only thing is that I accidentally put this through the dryer, and apparently you're not supposed to put it through the dryer. And so as you can see, the sleeve, the sleeves like shrunk. Probably gonna not end up selling that, but it was great in theory and I messed it up in the wash, so you know. And last from this first bag, this was a cool find. This is a Nautica size large, and it is like a parka because it like goes down to the knee, but it's this really heavy duty thick black puffer jacket. Again, not vintage, but should still sell probably for $50, I would think. This is just a little short, like green linen J. Jill cardigan, size large petite. I didn't even realize it was petite. This is a brand, I have never heard of this, but when I looked up the comps actually looked pretty decent. This is a Margaret O'Leary. It definitely sparked my interest when I saw this little like button tag, just an open front cardigan. And I think that comps might've been close to like $50. I could be wrong. This is a vintage Doncaster size extra large. This is a silk blend, and this is just like a little ribbed, short sleeve mock neck shirt. I pulled this thinking this was going to be Tommy Bahama, because it had all this embroidery down the front. And this is actually a Nat Nast size large, 100% silk. And when I look these up, these retail for a lot of money, and the like limited edition shirts, which this is one of them, can actually resell for a pretty good amount of money. Took a chance with this one because I have never sold Land's End before, but I have heard people say that Land's End is a good brand for them to sell, and this is a 3X, so great, great size. But this is just a like knee length wrap dress, and it's got like lemons and limes all around it, and it's that like stretchy spandex material. These are vintage men's Banana Republic, similar to the ones that I found in the last haul. These are 32 by 32s, and these are just like a washed green color. They are button fly, and here's the back patch on that. This is a vintage JCPenney's boys medium, and I could not pass this up. Look at how freaking cute this is. This has got to be probably from the 80s, I would think. I'm not really sure. It was so, so, so cute. This is a Banner 47 size medium. Definitely a women's medium because it's supposed to have that fit, but it's a Seattle Mariners, very like retro look. It's like that vintage wash to it, but it's obviously not vintage. There's that. This is a Nike beanie. I saw this and then I saw that and I was like, oh, I wonder if this is a special collab or something. Then I saw this on there. Tag is still on the inside and it is from 2017. No, I always love my vintage Eddie Bauer, size medium. This was one of my first pulls. I forgot that I got this. This is a Patagonia organic cotton large, which I never hardly ever find Patagonia. If I do, it's normally like really beat up and there's something wrong with it, but this appears to be great condition. This is a vintage Sergeant Leisure size extra large, and this is just an embroidered golf like pullover that says Maui on it. Again, no idea what this is. Big Mountain Brewing Company, Big Air Brew, Montana. It definitely seemed vintage. I've never seen this Anvil tag before, but it's like a colored Anvil tag, and it actually says authentic pigment on it. Size large, it's kind of beat up around the collar. It's got the small logo on the back, and then, or on the front, and then the big logo on the back. Found these Maeve by Anthropologie, size 28 petite. These are the Colette, and these are like a crop, kind of like a crop wide leg, in this really pretty purple color. There's kind of like this discoloration right here in the pocket, which you're not really gonna be able to see because I think I actually got most of it out. This was like really, really dark. I picked up just because they were just recently in the college football, like, you know, like top five teams. This is a women's size medium, just a Florida State long sleeve. This older style Seattle Seahawks long sleeve size extra large. And I think I'm going to give this to my dad and see if he wants it or see if it fits him, because he was kind of looking for one. This is a Air Jordan size medium sweatshirt. No, I just said in my last video that I'm really not gonna be picking up Nike anymore, but I think if it's Air Jordan or something like this rather than just basic Nike stuff, then I think it should sell okay, because most of the comps looked pretty decent for any of like the Air Jordan stuff that I have come across lately. That's right, I found these Lululemon leggings, and these are like the space dye color, and they actually still had the tag attached in them, which I feel like is super uncommon. And these are a size 8, just like the space dye. And I believe these were the Aligns. I don't think these were the Wonder Unders. I believe these were the Aligns. These are the last two things. So this is a like mid 2000s Nike shirt. This is a size extra large with that screen print. I believe this was like 2005, 2006, 2007 kind of time frame for Nike. Just a little basic t-shirt. Last but not least, I got really excited because I saw these and I was like, oh my gosh, are these gonna be JNCOs? I don't know. Unfortunately, they're not. They're BDG by Urban Outfitters, size 26. And when I looked up the comps, they were still like, the solds I think were still at least around $30. All right, well, now that you see the mound of clothes behind me, that is everything. We officially emptied out the two bags. Let me know what you thought of that haul down below. Thank you for watching. Like this video and subscribe to my channel to continue to see more bins, thrift hauls and things, because that is what I have been bringing you the most of. And other than that, I hope you have a great day, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.